Welcome to my physics video classes. Today's topic is conservation of charge. According to law of conservation of charge, the charge neither be created nor be destroyed. The charge neither be created nor be destroyed. It can only be transferred from one object to another object. In other words, we can say that in an isolated system, the total charge remains constant. This is my favorite statement, so I want to repeat. In an isolated system, the total charge remains constant. Okay, let's observe these statements in the following example. Suppose we have a isolated system which consists of object A and object B. Let's check the amount of charge on the object A. So object A having a positive charge of plus 20E, negative charge of minus 20E. We are writing the charge in terms of the elementary charge E. Okay, so the net charge is zero here. Net charge is zero. So the object A is having total 40 charges, 20 negative, 20 positive, though it is having 40, but the overall it is behaving as a neutral object. Now observe object B. It is having plus 14E, minus 14E. So this is also a neutral object because it is also having a net charge of zero. Now after the electrification, electrification is a process by which objects becomes charged. Now let's observe what happens to object A. Object A, it is having a total positive of 20E, negative of minus 18E. So it means the object A become positively charged. Check object B. It is having total positive of 14E, negative of minus 16E. So it is become negatively charged. So net charge is minus 2E on it. So here object A is becoming positively charged, object B is becoming negatively charged. So let's observe. Object A, initially it was neutral. After the electrification, the object A is becoming positively charged. So here we have to note down that this electrification process has not created any new positive charge in object A. Okay, no new positive charge is created in this whole system. No new positive charge has created in this whole system. In the same way, object B, which was neutral initially, object B was neutral, it has become negatively charged. Okay, negatively charged. So let me write this positive, the symbol lost. Okay, now object B, after the electrification, the object B becoming negatively charged. So here we have to note down that no new charge is created, no new negative charge is created in this whole system due to the electrification. Let's see how, what happened here. Okay, so in order to understand, so we have to focus on the system consisting of object A and object B. So total positive charge is simply the addition of this 20E and 14E, so plus 34E. Total negative of minus 34E. It means the system is having total, okay, this isolated system this system is having total 34 positive charge, 34 negative charge. It means the system is having total 68 charges in it. Okay. So now after the electrification, what we are getting? Let's focus on the system. So 20 positive, 14 negative, so altogether is becoming 34e. 18e, 16e, minus minus, so 34e. So after the electrification also, the total value is 68. So what does it mean? It means that in the isolated system, the total charge remains constant. We can see here, positive charge 34, positive 34, negative 34, negative 34. So here in this case, what the object A is becoming positively charged, the reason is it has lost some of its electrons. So we can observe the same thing here. Okay, so it has lost two electrons to this object B. So object A is becoming positively charged by plus 2e. That's it. Okay, so in this electrification process, okay, no new charge is created in the whole system. What happens? Only transfer of charges has taken place from one body to another body. That's it. Okay, so this transfer of charges has made the body positive and negative. So one point we have to note down, that whenever any object loses its electron, okay, whenever it loses electron, it becomes positively charged. Whenever any object gains the electron, it becomes negatively charged. So finally, our conclusion is, okay, so we cannot create the charge, we cannot destroy the charge. We can only transfer the charge from one object to another object in an isolated system. That is, the total charge remains constant. Let's observe the similar thing in another example. Let's consider object A. It is initially having plus 20 E positive, the negative value it is having is minus 17 E. It means it is already a positively charged object. Object B, it is having 14 E positive minus 17 E. It means this is also a charged body. It is negatively charged, minus 3 E. So both are initially, one is positive, another one negative. When we kept these two objects close to each other, say these two are conducting objects close to each other, the distribution of charge has taken place. After some time, we observe that, let's check the amount of charge on object A. It is plus 20e, amount of negative charge is minus 20e, the net charge is 0. Object B, we observed 14e minus 14e, the net charge is 0. It means the objects are neutral. Both object A and object B are neutral. Okay, so here, before the object A was positively charged, okay, as we kept in contact, we are getting the neutral. It means object A has destroyed its positive charge. No. In an isolated system, we cannot destroy any charge. Okay, even for object B. Okay, so what to remember here? We cannot destroy the charge. We can only transfer the charge. Let's see what is happening here by looking at the system. Okay, so here, let's focus on the system. The system is having altogether positive charge equal to 20 plus 14 plus 34 E, negative charge of minus 34 E, 17. Okay, so here also, in case 2 also, plus 34 E, minus 34 E. What does it mean? It means that in an isolated system, the charge remains constant. What happened here? What happened here is, look at here, the object A. The object A has gained some of the electrons. Look at here. The object A has gained this part. Focus on this part. Before, nothing here. Okay. Now it has gained few electrons. Okay. Only in this system. So this whole thing is a system. In this system, only transfer of electrons has taken place from one body to another body. That's it. Okay. That's it. No destruction of charges has taken place. So what to remember here? In an isolated system, the total charge remains constant. We cannot destroy any charge. We can only transfer the charge from one body to another body in the system. Okay. Now, let's observe the real life example of law of conservation of charge by rubbing a glass rod with a silk cloth. Initially, the glass rod and silk cloth both are neutral. Okay, it means they are having equal amount of positive charge and negative charge in them. Okay, now by rubbing the glass rod with a silk cloth, we observe that the glass rod is becoming positively charged, the silk cloth is becoming negatively charged. So we already studied the conservation of charge. That is, in an isolated system, this is a isolated system of glass rod and silk cloth. So what to remember? So here only the transfer of charge takes place from one body to another body. That's it. Okay. We cannot create any new charge in this system. We cannot destroy any charge present in the system. That's it. Okay. So here in this case, the glass rod has gained the positive charge because it has lost its electrons. So in this exam, in this case, so it has lost 8 electrons from the picture. So it becomes plus 80. At the same time, the silk cloth has gained whatever the electrons lost by the glass rod. So it has gained all the 8 electrons. Okay, one body loses the electron, another body gains the electrons. That's it. Okay, so here, what happened here? Only transfer of electrons. The transfer of electrons can only possible. So you can also use the word charge, whatever it may be. Especially the transfer of the electrons makes the body positive, okay, and makes another body negative. That's it. So this is called law of conservation of charge. Once again, I repeat, okay, we cannot create the charge, we cannot destroy the charge. What we can do? We can simply transfer the charge from one body to another body. When we transfer the charge from one body to another body, one body becomes positively charged, another becomes negatively charged. Thank you.